Silent if you are so kind. Sit down and keep silent. Sit down and keep silent, Mr. Pope. Please sit down and keep silent if you can. You are transdisciplinary, keep silent, please. Where are my young people? Catherine Barba, Stanian. That's a good one. Also, Dean. Okay. Anna, where's my wife?
Here.
I said sit down and keep silent. Okay. We met. Please don't speak. Because it's a special moment. You hear something very special. Traditional and religious Romanian songs by Psalmodia Transylvanica choral, which is one of them. Please keep silent. Yes, one of the most famous chorals in Romania, and is directed by Professor Dr. Father Vasile Stanciu, who is the Dean of the Faculty of Orthodox Theology in this university. Please.
Oh,
You have to resist a little bit. The Congress is not finished, it's polluting. So, we have now a guest speaker. The guest speaker of our Atlas reception is the president of the university, Ioan-Aurel, and president of the Romanian Academy. As you know, he couldn't come because of the United States. So the word will be pronounced by our vice president, Ioan Bolovan.
Good evening. I hope you have a wonderful day following the day started the conference, and I was told it was a very fruitful and a very exciting day. So I hope this day was like yesterday too. I have a very difficult task to deliver a paper on behalf of Professor Ioan-Aurel Pop, and I dare to add some slides just in order to provide you with a very short insight in the history of Transylvania. So, what is Transylvania? Perhaps some of you are already told. Transylvania is one of the major provinces of contemporary Romania, and starting with the Middle Ages, with the dawn of the Middle Ages, 1,000 years ago, the Romanians were joined here by several people which would later influence to varying degrees the destiny and the history of this land. It is not only the largest, but I may say the most beautiful part of Romania. This part of Romania is whose total population consists of 6.5 million people, mostly Romanians, according to the last census taken in October 2011. Around 77% Romanians, around 20% Hungarians, Roma population 1.6%, German population, Slav population, Armenians, Greeks, and many others ethnic groups, counting not more than a few thousand people. We may say that along the centuries, relations between the native Romanians and the other peoples that inhabited the Transylvanian space were neither pure or immaculate. It is the history, and like in other parts of Europe, the past is full with light, but with darkness at the same time. So, it was most certainly the case in other European countries where the majority population lived alongside significant ethnic or confessional minorities like here in Transylvania. In Transylvania, but in the rest of Romania, the native population is the Romanian one, the Romanians being a Neo-Latin population like French people, like Italians, like Spaniards, Spanish people, Portuguese, and so on. Romanian people is in this part of Europe the largest people. And it's somehow strange that the Neo-Latin here is surrounded by Slavs and by Hungarians belonging to another important major population group. What you have to know about this province? Romania, generally speaking, holds a heritage unique within Europe, but Transylvania is the only place in Europe with such a complex cultural and confessional heritage. It is only here you can see monuments representing the Romanesque or Gothic style. You may find here in Cluj-Napoca, in other Transylvanian cities, buildings to the Renaissance styles, Byzantine, Baroque, or modern style, Art Nouveau, Jugendstil. It is a heritage, as I told you before, unique in Romania, and Transylvania from this point of view is, as I told you before, the most beautiful part of Romania, and I honestly enjoy being and living here in Transylvania. Well, in order to have a very short insight in the history of Transylvania, we have to say that the destiny of this province can be only comprehended on background of a wider area comprising several countries, amongst them the two other neighboring principalities, Romanian principalities, Valacia, Țara Românească, and Moldavia. From a political point of view, at the beginning of the Middle Ages, Transylvania was not a Romanian principality in political sense, but later, because of absolute Romanian demographic majority, it became a part of Romanian kingdom at the end of the First World War in 1918. A short outline of the history of Transylvania. There were three very important stages in the history of Transylvania. Starting with the 20th century until 1541, the middle of the 16th century, Transylvania was an autonomous voivodate, a part of the Hungarian kingdom, and starting with the middle of the 14th century started the discrimination of the Romanian by the Hungarian kings, because after 1366, some laws issued by the Hungarian king Sigismund of Luxembourg starting the discrimination of the Romanian Orthodox population. Then between 1541-1699, it was a stage of, let's say, an autonomous principality under the Ottoman authority, and the discrimination of the Romanians continuing with the so-called three privileged nation, Unio Triu Nationum. The third stage is between 1699 and 1918. During this period, Transylvania was an autonomous principality under the Habsburg rule, and in this period started the national movement for emancipation. We can talk about 200 years when Romanians started to fight to get their freedom. Some leaders of this Transylvanian voivodat in the framework of Hungarian kingdom, Iancu de Hunedoara, one of the well-known rulers in this part of Europe due to his fights against Ottomans, and he succeeded to defend Belgrade in 1456, so he stopped the Ottoman offensive towards the Central Europe. And below is his son Matea Corvin, and like Iancu de Hunedoara, who was Romanian. It was one of the most important kings in the history of Hungary, Matea Corvin, between 1858 and 1490, and he was born here in Cluj. The church alongside this street near the university was built by Matea Corvin as a tribute paid to the Cluj, the city where he was born. In the right side is the castle of Hunedoara, the property of Iancu de Hunedoara and his son Matea Corvin. Then between 1541 and 1699, when Transylvania was a principality autonomous under Ottoman rule, the discrimination amongst Romanians continued. There are several rulers here, especially Sigismund Bathory, because it is very important to know in 1581, Sinches Bulvatori, the ruler of Transylvania and king of Poland, established the University of Cluj. So our roots, Babes-Bolyai University, is rooted in this act from 1581. A shift was noticed after 1699 as far as the statue of the Romanians is concerned, because the Habsburg tried to oppose the Romanians amongst the Hungarian nobility, amongst Saxon leaders. The Habsburg did not plan radical political change for Transylvania and never fully supported all Romanian claims, but it managed to blackmail the Hungarian, the Saxon leaders into relative submission. I told you that the Hungarian nobility, the Saxon rulers and the secular nobility were the so-called Unio Trium Nationum, the three privileged political nation in Transylvania. Well, we can notice, let's say, a step forward as far as the Romanians are concerned, because the Habsburg supported some their rights, some their claims, but never totally supported their demand. In this period, especially in the 19th century, during the so-called nationalities centuries, the Romanians, the leaders of the Romanian national movement in Transylvania, carried out ample mass campaign with various methods, reaching the most remote village and clearly sustaining to all Romanians what national freedom entailed and what the future destiny of all Romanian could look like. It was a national movement not only here in Transylvania for the Romanians, but we can find similar samples in this part of Europe, in Central Europe, in the Habsburg Empire, for Slavs, for Serbs, for Czech, for Polish too. And now, coming closer, the 1918, the end of the First World War, it was, let's say, the most important year in the history of Romania till that, and from some point of view, it is the most important moment in the entire history of the Romanians. Why? Because then, at the end of the First World War, Transylvania was joined with Old Kingdom, with smaller Romania. It was very important because this act in December, 1st of December 1918, is the national holiday of Romania. This process started in October when the leaders of the Romania issued a declaration of independence, submitted in the Parliament of Budapest by the deputy Alexandru Vaida Voivod, later Prime Minister of Romania. And during in the second part of the October and during the November, the power was taken over by the Romanian National Council, and the public order was maintained by the Romanian guards. In this month, it was very important that Romania didn't turn against their ancestor rulers. There was no violence against Hungarians, against Germans, against Czechs. It was very important that Romanians behave responsible in these very difficult weeks, because it was after the 4 years of war. It was a very difficult situation because the Germans' armies retreated in Transylvania. It was very difficult because the Hungarians didn't want Transylvania to be joined with Romania. It was a state of tension, but Romanians behave very responsible in this respect. It is important that Transylvania was united with Romania in a democratic manner, because it was 1,228 delegates who decided in this respect, and more than 100,000 people gathered in Alba Iulia approved this, this decision. The act of 1st of December 1980 marked the end of a process. It was not unique in Europe, because Polish, because Czech, Slovak, the Serbs went through this process of unification, and even earlier the Germans, Italians went through the same process. So this completion of the Romanian national state in 1980, it was similar with other nations in this part of Europe. It was not something exotic in this part of Europe. It was natural and a similar process like other nations went through. What is important to have in mind after this short outline of the history of Transylvania? It is unique because this wooden church, there are many of these wooden churches in Transylvania, are listed as on the cultural heritage of the world. The fortified churches belonging to the Saxon in Transylvania, you have some picture in the top, are in the same time unique in this part of Europe. Some castles, synagogues, Orthodox Church, Roman Catholic Church, Protestant Church are this heritage for the inhabitants of present-day Transylvania and present-day Romania, and hopefully we will be so wise in order to preserve them and to have as model for tolerance and peaceful coexistence in this part of Romania and Europe. Thank you very much.